Hi, everyone. I'm Greg, and I lead Health AI at Google. In a world where it feels like we're making the impossible possible, it's so important to take a beat and evaluate whether we're building the right tools for the right people in the right way. Today, I want to talk to you about how we're using partnership to do just that. At Google Health, we work with partners both to validate and improve our technology and to go beyond research to drive real-world impact. First, let's talk about ultrasound. Ultrasound is a radiation-free, versatile, and increasingly more accessible early disease detection tool. It can provide real-time, dynamic views of fetuses, hearts, lungs, and more. You're probably familiar with big ultrasound machines in hospitals. But in recent years, sensor technology has evolved to make ultrasound devices significantly more portable and more affordable, with many handheld devices available today for a fraction of the price. In most cases, experts, who often train for years, are required to conduct the ultrasound exam and interpret the images. But in many lower resource settings, we have a shortage of such specialists. This is an area where AI can help. In collaboration with global research teams, we have built AI models to interpret ultrasound images and identified important information, like gestational age. This can help non-experts acquire and interpret ultrasound images to triage high-risk patients simply by sweeping the handheld probe across mom's belly. Although our research has shown that AI models could do these things, that doesn't necessarily mean that AI would work in the communities that we are most interested in impacting. For that to happen, it's critical that we work with local partners, adapting our technology to real-world conditions. Today, we're thrilled to announce two new research partnerships to help improve our ultrasound AI technology. We're working with Chang Gung Memorial Hospital, or CGMH, in Taiwan for breast ultrasound, and Jacaranda Health in Kenya for maternal health ultrasound. We chose these two regions and partners to ensure that our technology works for the caregivers and for the patients who need it most. For breast cancer screening, we're pushing on ultrasound because we know that conventional mammograms are often less effective for Asian populations due to the prevalence of high breast density tissue. And in sub-Saharan Africa, where maternal mortality remains high, ultrasound can be a useful tool for triaging risky cases throughout a pregnancy. While research inspires me as a scientist myself, research alone doesn't save lives. Some of our other AI tools are more mature, and after rigorous efficacy and safety evaluation, we're ready to make these models available to millions of people. One such opportunity is in the fight against tuberculosis. TB is a disease that still leads to 1.6 million deaths annually, primarily in low-resource settings. Despite significant progress, mortality rates increased in both 2020 and 2021. But TB is treatable. What we need is cost-effective screening solutions to help catch the disease early and reduce community spread. For the past few years, we've published research showing that our AI models can detect signs of TB in chest x-rays as accurately as radiologists. We've even validated this research through a prospective clinical trial in Zambia. I'm excited to announce a new research collaboration with a coalition headed by Right to Care, a nonprofit organization with extensive experience in TB care within Africa. Their mission is to make AI-powered TB screening widely available across sub-Saharan Africa. This partnership comes with a promise to deliver 100,000 free AI-powered TB screenings over the course of the collaboration. We're glad to be playing a part in the long journey to eradicate TB worldwide. But the reach of AI in healthcare goes beyond disease detection and extends into treatment. There's a huge opportunity for AI to transform cancer treatment in particular. We've been collaborating with Mayo Clinic to improve radiotherapy treatment planning and have some meaningful updates to share on that work. Radiotherapy is one of the most common cancer treatments, used to treat more than half of all cancers in the United States. But planning for radiotherapy treatment is a manual, time-consuming process for clinicians. The most labor-intensive step is a process called contouring, where clinicians painstakingly draw lines on CT scans to separate areas of cancer from nearby healthy tissue that could be damaged by radiation during treatment. The process of contouring can take up to 7 hours for a single patient. 3 years ago, we partnered with Mayo Clinic to start exploring how AI could help clinicians spend less time on contouring. Much like Google Maps can detect buildings and roads using AI, we build technology that could detect organs in CT scans, quickly outlining them for review by specialists. Now, together with Mayo Clinic, we're able to bring this jointly developed model to clinicians in real-world radiotherapy cases moving forward. This project is part of a broader collaboration with Google Cloud, focused on transforming health technology into regulated tools that can be easily deployed to help thousands of patients. The future of AI in healthcare is bright, and Google is working hard to bring technology from research to reality.